Now, we all know if you're shopping for supermodels, skinny is usually better than fat. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But what about laptops? Let's see how skinny does in today's Gadgetpon.
Averitech is making the jump into the world of ultra-portables that are ultra-affordable with the N3400 laptop. Weighing 3.8 pounds and just under an inch thick, this thin and light is packed full of power. You get an Intel dual-core processor, up to 8 gigs of RAM, a 250-gig hard drive, and a 13-inch widescreen display. So don't say Averitech never gave you nothing for $800.
Sexy lady!
Yes, here it is. This ultra-portable is definitely more stylish than... Here's yesterday's Acer, real quick, before you... Look, this is yesterday's Acer, right?
Yeah.
This is what it looked like. It's pretty good. There it is. But this one definitely is. Can you see this right here? All aluminum body, right there. Gives it a sleek feel. It is a little thicker and heavier than the Acer, and, of course, the MacBook Air.
Yeah.
But... It's not so bad, but it is prettier. What do you think? Is it thin and light enough to?
I think it is. I mean, it gets to the point where weight might be a deciding factor for some people. No removable battery, which could be an issue, but stylistically, it is a lot better. But the weight is just on the cusp of being something that you don't mind throwing into a book bag and something that you feel is just a little bit too heavy to carry around all the
time. Yeah, but I guess this is like I feel like this is a little too heavy. I would never throw this in a passenger bag. It's just too much for me.
It's good for thwapping a zombie, though.
Yes, it is. Now, quite possibly, what I believe is one of the most important aspects of like any of these laptops is the ease of the keyboard and the touchpad, because sometimes you get your wrist hits it or something, it's weird, you have to get used to it.
Yeah.
How about this one?
It did pretty well. The keyboard has wide keys, it's really comfortable to type on, you don't have a real big getting used to it period. The touchpad is not only multi-touch, but it also has this icon mode that will let you launch a browser or email or your own macro.
The icons are actually on the
Yeah, they're actually on the trackpad itself. The problem is that once you go into icon mode, which can accidentally happen by tapping it in the wrong corner, it actually disables the touchpad.
Part. Oh, you only have that little middle part, too.
Once you're in icon mode, so you can't actually mouse around. So you'll find yourself in that mode, and then we were like, oh, okay, this is probably something that's easily disabled. No, it's not.
What do you mean?
We went through every menu and tried disabling it in 1,000 different ways, and somehow it became disabled, and then somehow it became re-enabled, and we still can't get it undone again. So.
Well, maybe it's supposed to be like that. Maybe it's a surprise for everyone.
It's like, hey, surprise. You might be getting work done or launching the calculator app 14 times in a row. Either way, something's happening when you're touching it.
Unexpected.
It's not a feature.
Okay, well, it does have a much faster processor than the Acer yesterday, 2.16 versus 1.4 gigahertz.
Yes.
Which is a lot, but one less gig of RAM, 3 gigs in this one. Did it perform better than the Acer?
Yes, but I think the RAM really hurt it because it didn't perform better by much. In our regular PC Mark Vantage test, it scored about 3,000 points, which is only 100 points more than the Acer. Now, in real world terms, that means it takes about 45 seconds to boot up and launch a web browser, whereas the Acer was about 55 seconds. So overall, it's good, but it's just not great.
Okay, well, this is going to run you about $800. It's not so bad, but do you think it's a good deal?
It's almost a good deal. I mean, if it were a little faster, then we could fully recommend it, but the Acer from yesterday, it's $250 less, and it's just about as fast.
Now, I have a question. What do you think? You know, sometimes we get these things, and they're almost there, they're quite there, or something else is better. Are they cutting back because of cost, or is just the people behind it don't know what
they're trying to find the right balance. They're trying to make the most money. They're trying to sell it for the most money they can, obviously, from the consumer. So they figure, oh, we'll sell this one with a faster processor, but we're going to skimp on the RAM because we think 3 gigs sounds like enough.
So it's not because the programmers, the people behind this, the technicians aren't as capable. They're all capable of doing it. They just choose not to do it.
Sure. I mean, there's trade-offs. It's like, so for the price point they're going for, we think they missed it. We think they could have a little bit more RAM. It could be a bit faster.
And we're saying
for
we'd rather pay.
If not, pull it down a little bit, get the price down, and then you're competing with the laptop from yesterday, the Acer.
That makes sense. Yeah. All right. Well, where are we going to give this one?
We like the design. The features are good. But again, the price is a little too high for the performance mark. So 3.5 out of 5 is what you should be seeing
there. That's for the price.
There's the half of it.
There it is.
And there you go. There it was. Thank you. That's it for today's GadgetPron. Remember, for even more of the latest news on computers, games, and tech, check out the all-new G4TV.com/thefeed.